My name is Carolyn Kruger. I'm a retired LAUSD teacher. I live in Morro Bay. I and 9 other citizens are here because we're concerned about SB 1277 that was signed into law on October 2nd. And SB 1277 deals with genocide education, and it identifies the California Teachers Collaborative on Holocaust and Genocide Education as the purveyor of professional development for California teachers. We're concerned about this collaborative, and in your package, on the top of the package is a flyer about our letter stating this concern. We have circulated a letter that is signed by 900 plus citizens so far and counting. And this has a QR code where you can access the letter and see the signatories. And it starts out, as educators, parents, students, and community stakeholders, we ask you not to contract for professional development with the California Teachers Collaborative for Holocaust and Genocide Education until its teacher training program, number 1, includes scholars on Palestine, 2, expels the Anti-Defamation League and other organizations that conflate anti-Semitism with anti-Zionism, and 3, develops a transparent and accountable governance structure. Inside the package are alternatives in terms of teacher training. There's an explanation of the Teachers Collaborative, its constitution, what it stands for, and also a reading list. So we would like to open a conversation with you that will continue after tonight to help you find the best people to train teachers in this subject matter. We feel that this collaborative is biased. I'll just read one more bit. They work with the ADL, and the ADL's agenda is clear: deny Israel's genocide in Gaza and accuse those who argue otherwise of siding with terrorists. This is wrong. Our students need and deserve unbiased education about past and current genocides. We need education, not indoctrination. Thank you.
Thank you. David Yowie.
Good evening. My name is David Yowie. I live in Morro Bay. I had nothing prepared. I would like to read something that a friend asked to be read. Her name is Vicki Carroll. She was a librarian at San Luis Obispo High School. She asked us to deliver her message since she could not be here. Here is her message. SLO High used to do an extensive unit on World War II, especially the genocide, with a focus on the resistance that helped the Jews. Half of our library history collection was books on World War II. We don't need any help from non-teachers to teach the curriculum that aligns with the state test. The teachers who taught this excellent unit was Joanne White. Since SLO High is on the quarter system, there are only about 12 weeks to focus on a subject. That is a lot to cover if you are going to prepare for the state test. So that I offer to the board. We are hopeful that we can have communication and prevent the school boards from being involved with a form of takeover that would indoctrinate our children instead of educate. There is a difference between history and myth, and a lot of what might be considered anti-Semitism is based on religion and based on myth and not true history. The Bible is not a reference for history. That last part is from myself, David Yo. So thank you very much for listening, and hopefully we can speak again at other times. We don't want to be radical. We're not looking to cause problems. We're just asking that that our children not be forced into the mentality of the children of the Zionist Israel. And they're overlooking and not seeing a reality. And the people that are behind these bills are basically the people that are causing a genocide right now. And they're not honorable. So, and please don't misconstrue. There's a difference between Jewish people, Hebrews, Zionists. We have to be cautious. My time. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. Jan Meslin.
It's right before me. I'm sorry.
We're all just.
We need to go in the order that we have.
We have our cards, please.
Thank you.
I'm Jan Meslin. I live in Cayucos. And I just want to say that first, every single day, my heart breaks because this genocide in Palestine continues. And children are dying, especially. That breaks my heart the most. And the whole world just kind of seems to let it go on. So that's I just want to say that up front. The Anti-Defamation League lesson plans in its Echoes and Reflections unit reflect a bunch of concerns. And you can click on any lesson plan on how to talk about the Israel-Hamas conflict, and up pops the ADL Stay Informed page, which paints anti-Israel protesters as anti-Semitic. Additionally, the page links to an ADL college campus report card that awards higher grades to colleges that have passed student senate resolutions against boycotts of Israel. Not only that, but the ADL has a history and ongoing pattern of attacking social justice movements led by communities of color, queer people, immigrants, Muslims, Arabs, and other marginalized groups, while aligning itself with right-wing leaders and perpetrators of state violence. In addition to our concerns about the ADL and the lack of representation of Palestine scholars in the collaborative, we note that the state of California has outsourced genocide education to a collaborative with no accountability to the public. It's unclear how an organization becomes a member of the collaborative, how long the organization serves as a member, and whether the collaborative is subject to the Brown Act or the Public Records Act. And that is unacceptable. So after World War II, they said, never again, the Jews said, never again will there be a genocide, but there's a genocide going on right now. And so that's why so many millions of people around the world are really upset. And we don't want this to get into our schools. That we want it to be truth told in our education. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Donna.
Thank you. And I apologize for the insistence of the order of speaking, but the letter that we've been referring to was presented to the Santa Barbara School District as well. And I've highlighted certain sections of this letter that was signed by several hundred people. It's an open letter to California parents, educators, school boards, superintendents, county offices of education, and stakeholders. Recently, California Governor Newsom signed SB 1277, which establishes the problematic collaborative. That's the crucial point that we are trying to express here today, is that the collaborative is a composition of 14 organizations, over half of which are supporters of Israel, including the powerful Anti-Defamation League, ADL, that often works under the name of one of its thematic units. echoes and reflections. So they don't often identify themselves as the Anti-Defamation League. Rather, they use a pseudonym known as Echoes and Reflections, which is also the name of one of their units for teaching, reteaching history. Thank you for listening to us. We hope we get to come and have your cookies again sometime. Thank you.
Thank you. Jim Silva.
My name is Jim Silva, and I'm a retired elementary school and secondary school teacher from Lompoc Unified. Okay, the Israel lobby wants us to teach more genocide education. We already adequately teach it as part of our social studies curriculum, so why? They say there's an uptick in anti-Semitism, but that's not true. They make up their own statistics, including any criticism of Israel and any anti-genocide protests, no matter how peaceful, even if they're put on by Jews, as anti-Semitic. But why would they lie about it and push this on us now? They're making an issue out of it, one, to distract us from the genocide that our government and Israel are committing now and over the past year, and also to continue the constant narrative of Israel as the victim. So we will continue to support the expansionist, racist, white European colonial settlement in the middle of Arab lands, including its removal and extermination of the natives. That's a common characteristic of all colonial settler societies, including ours. The World Court found enough evidence of genocide twice to recommend indictments of Israel's leaders Netanyahu and Gilad. The International Criminal Court has requested arrest warrants for them for extermination, starvation, intentionally attacking civilian populations, war crimes, and crimes against humanity. That classroom discussion would be quite a learning experience, wouldn't it? But the curriculum the collaboration wants to foist on you and our kids won't include this genocide, the one that's happening now and the one that's most relevant to all of us. Because this genocide is our genocide, bought and paid for out of your pockets and mine with our tax money, pushed for by our bought and paid for politicians we voted in, and allowed and enabled by silence and lack of moral courage. Over 60% of all Americans want this genocide to end and want our government's support for it to stop. This collaboration curriculum won't prevent future Holocausts because its main purpose is to continue this one. It isn't mandated that you have to waste money and precious teacher time and staff time on this unfortunately harmful indoctrination. We have a moral duty to ourselves and to our kids to not teach propaganda supporting genocide. I urge you to bypass it. We can do better than this, and we already are.
Thank you.
Is there anyone else in the room who wishes to address the board? Okay, moving on to Zoom. All right. Okay, thank you very much. We will move on to our superintendent's updates. 7.01, business and budget update.